receive with an open heart. We are glad that your parents can be here with relatives and friends on this day before God who will share the sacrament of marriage. May the Lord exalt you on this day of your joy. May the Lord send you help from above and watch over you. And may the desires of your hearts, which begins with Christ, your family, your friends, and your co-ministers, fulfill all of your requests. from the wisdom literature of Song of Songs through the Hebrew tradition into the Christian church. The seal of the permanence of God's relationship comes to us in the sacraments. With the same strength and permanence of God's covenant to our ancestors. And even if the ancestors didn't do too well on their end, God was always there. Set me as a seal on your heart. We are sealed in baptism. We are sealed in confirmation. We are sealed in holy waters. We're sealed in the sacrament of marriage. And before us today, this scripture will come to fulfillment. And for you married folk out there, and all those in relationships, you know that it is always something to work at, work towards, and work with. In Paul's letter to the Colossians that Diane proclaimed for us, we hear what these virtues are. But it's all about letting the word of Christ dwell richly within us. It's always God's initiative, just as God brought Josh and Allie together, just as those we love, some part of God's plan, which becomes revealed to us little by little, day to day. And those virtues, compassion, kindness, and gentleness, and humility, not something that you will do in your lives, but something that God will do through you in your lives. But knowing you, as we all do, it will not be anything new. It will be a further life of virtue, now strengthened and sealed by the sacrament of marriage. The gospel that they chose for us on being the salt of the earth and the light of the world was a challenge to the Matthew community, as is proclaimed in what Matthew put together as the Sermon on the Mount. The people, the early church, the disciples, the first ones, not knowing what was going on, were always challenged by Jesus talking about himself and his ministry and what he was doing, and they were so taken up with that. But I think the larger challenge was when he told the disciples what they were to be. In John's Gospel, Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. I am the way, the truth, and life. I'm the good shepherd." And they would certainly pat him on the back, we might explain, say, "Oh, you're entangled." But when he tells the disciples, "You are the salt of the earth, and you are the light of the world," that's why in all confidence through the power of the Spirit, he could depart from them and leave them in his stead, being his presence. For all the good that you do, the talents that you have and you share with us all the time, will now have a deeper reality in Christ because of your sacrament of marriage. You are already salt and light. You give flavor, certainly, to your family, to your friends, and those who have studied, worked with, and performed for. And you are constantly a light through the darkness of COVID and sickness and disappointments and just what life brings along to you. And it won't be all that easy forward, so you may have a few more nervous days. But God is permanent with you, sealed. Make the apostle of yours be the salt and the light. As they went before the world last Sunday to make this contract, it was really day one of what musically we could call an octave. Today is the eighth day. But the theology of the eighth day is the theology of the fulfillment of God's kingdom. The first day, the Dies Domini, is Sunday, this day, the day of the Lord. But we know that the two most important feasts are celebrated for 8 days. The Nativity of the Lord is an 8-day celebration. Second, third, fourth, eighth day of Christmas. It's Christmas Day
eight times. It begins with the historical life of Jesus born into the world, completely human, and it ends with the celebration of his complete divinity as well. The eighth day. The eighth day is the fulfillment of the beginning of that incarnation. And of course, the greatest Sunday of all is Easter. And we have 8 days of Easter to celebrate the resurrection of Christ. That is done on purpose, because when we get back to the beginning, it's not starting over. It's the fulfillment of all that has happened. So today we celebrate with you the octave. If we can ask Matt to do octaves on the piano, but you really have to stretch your fingers, and he's very capable of doing that. And the new musicians out there, you know that. It's the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Everything is contained therein. And that's what this octave has been for you. This is the eighth day, and a day of complete fulfillment and joy as we look forward to celebrating with you the sacrament of marriage. My dear friends in Christ, you have come together in Resurrection Church that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of all of us gathered here. Christ abundantly blesses your love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties of marriage and mutual and lasting fidelity. And so in the presence of the church gathered here today, I ask you to state your intentions. Alessandra Carmela and Joshua Michael, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in the sacrament of marriage?
We have.
Will you continue to love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives?
We will.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
We will.
My friends, it's your intention to give to each other the sacrament of marriage. Now join your hands together and now face each other and declare your consent before God and God's people. To you, Joshua Michael, take Alessandra Carmela to be your wife. You continue to be true to her in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. Will you continue to love and honor her all the days of your life?
I will. I do.
Long as you together. To you, Alessandra Carmela, take Joshua Michael to continue to be your husband. You promise to be true to him in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. Will you continue to love and honor him all the days of your life? But I'm prepared to consent and share the sacrament of marriage before us gathered here today as a church. May the Lord with much goodness strengthen your vows and fill you both with many blessings. And what God has joined together, no one must ever divide. You hold your hands out together with your ring. Each of you, I will bless your ring. Come and extend their hands with me. Lord our God, bless these rings and continue to consecrate Allie and Josh together in this common love. May the rings that they wear be a symbol of their true faith in each other and always remind them of their love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Having given witness to the staff of the marriage that they have shared before us today, we now pray for them and for all God's people. And our response is, keep us in your love. We pray for Allie and Josh on their eighth day, the fulfillment of God's gift of love to them in the sacrament of marriage. May they continue to have God's assistance at every moment, the constant support of friends, the rich blessing of children, a warm love reaching out to others, and good health lasting long into old age. We pray to the Lord. Keep us in your love. We pray for the parents and families and friends of Josh and Allie who are here today.
that God may continue to bless them as they show their love and support for this new marriage. We pray to the Lord.
Behold the Lamb of God, the Lord Jesus, who takes away our sins and seals us with the gift of love. How blessed are those coming to the banquet of the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Join us in our new song, 813.